How practical are the XREAL Air 2 Pro Air glasses combined with the new XREAL Beam Pro? Can these really be the Air glasses of our wanted future? Well, my name is Dilmer and welcome to my channel. And in today's video, we're going to be answering all of these hot questions. If we have XREAL pair of Air glasses, why do we need this device, right? You might be thinking about that as you're watching this video. Wouldn't it be sufficient just to get the Air glasses? Well, the main reason is how much more functionality you get in terms of true AR. Without it, you simply stuck with the screen mirror and device that is close to your eyes. It's still very cool, but not the complete package. So here's my opinion of where getting the Beam Pro makes a lot more sense. The Beam Pro adds functionality by making use of the hardware, which includes the Snapdragon processor. This hardware provides multitasking features, a spatial video playback, and also the Nebula operating system, which is built on top of Android 14. This is a big selling point to me because now we're dealing with an operating system that provides Google Play with thousands and thousands of apps, if not millions, that you can use within your AR glasses. Another cool feature about the Beam Pro is that it uses accelerometer and also gyro features, which in turn adds a pointer and touch controls for spatial interactions. The Beam Pro makes your AR glasses way more useful by making your classic 2D apps or games be usable in 3D spaces. You can also take and view 3D photos, spatial videos by using the dual 50 megapixel stereo cameras that are placed at 50 millimeters from each other. This is really cool because it mimics human eyes. The same separation that we have when we look at something is going to be the same separation between the lenses. There is also an 8 megapixel front camera that you can use for selfies. It comes with a decent LCD display of 6.5 inches. The Beam Pro may not be a very high-end Android device, which I agree is not, but its sole purpose of providing a media system with spatial capabilities to XREAL Air glasses makes it way more compelling to me. I'm gonna start with the Beam Pro so that I can show you what it has. You guys can see the box and the two lenses that we were talking about in the introduction. There's also a couple of buttons in here that allow you to change modes, also volume controls. And then this one is going to be for display on and off. And you can see here a couple of different codes that we have. Let's go ahead and get this open. So you're gonna have this here that allows you to open it up and we can get it out. Awesome, and we have this beautiful Beam Pro spatial device. And let's get it out here. And in the box we have, you know, the device itself. There's some protection here, which is awesome. See if we can get this open without ruining everything. And the display is a 6.5 display LCD, like I show you on and talk to you in the beginning of the video. And it has 60 Hertz, right? So this actually looks really nice and really high quality. Here are the lenses. There's also a flashlight right here that you can, you know, you can also use. The modes is going to allow you to do, if you want to have basically the content be anchored to your body, if you're sitting and watching a movie, then this button is going to allow you to toggle it to that. You can also toggle the mode or change the mode to be able to follow the content is going to smoothly follow you. And then the volume controls and also the display on and off. And then the lenses are pretty big though. I wasn't expecting something as, you know, as nice as this, because the price of this is going to be $199 for the 6 gigs of RAM. And then you also get 128 gigs of space. And then if you wanna bump it up a little bit, you can do the 249, which is 8 gigs of RAM. And then you get the 256, like I mentioned. Then on this side here, you also get, if you wanna extend the space. So if you were to ask me, or should I get the low end or the high end as far as the space and RAM is concerned, I don't really think getting the high end, I would recommend it, because you can basically use the micro SD card to extend it to be 1 terabyte. So there's also here the front end camera. This one is going to be 8 megapixels. And then we have the 50 megapixels cameras for each one of the eyes. And then there's a, you know, XREAL logo in here. And then on the very bottom though, if you notice, we have two different connections. And there's gonna be two different drawings in here indicating one of them is gonna be for power. This power connection is really cool because it allows you to do 27 watts. And what that means is that it's going to allow you to do fast charging. And not only that, it's gonna be about 5 times faster than a regular 5-watt connection. The other thing about having two ports, USB-C ports in here that are cool, is you can have one connected to the display, which is gonna be connected to the actual glasses, while the other one is still charging. So it gives you about 3 to 3.5 hours of battery life. We also should have a couple of different paperwork that you can also look at. And then here's going to be the tool that allows you to eject the actual micro USB card. There we go. So as soon as you get it open, we can start looking at what we have in here. And this opens nicely. Really, really cool though. It looks high quality. And I opened many things in the past, so this is pretty nice. So this is gonna be the traveling case that you get with the XREAL logo up front. And then it's like a flat area here on the side. And then we can get it open, you know, by doing this. There's just a couple of different areas in here. Actually, there are some manuals inside that are hidden on the very bottom. And then we have a little cleaning cloth in here. It's pretty nice though, really small, but I think it's nice. And then if we go back here to the actual glasses, now we can get them out. So if you want to look at it on the inside, we have the XREAL logo inside as well. So now on the glasses themselves, this is what you'll get, right? There's more covers in here to protect them, which is nice. This one is going to be basically a detachable USB-C connector, which is cool because it doesn't need to be attached like the older version of the XREAL that I used to use. Used to be that the cable was connected at all times. So this is nice, so you don't have that cable on the way. And you can always, you know, switch the cables if you want to get a different type of cable. But this is pretty sturdy and pretty high quality though. This one is probably going to be the one that goes on the glasses versus this end is going to be the one that connects to the phone. So let's see what else we have in here. I'm just gonna try to get it open. And then more protection in here, and then also looks like a code in there. So if you get this out though, we can see that this is going to be the light shield that is going to protect the glasses from light coming in as well. So we can get it out in here, get the plastic, and that's what you should expect to receive as well. So let's put that in here. We have speakers, which are going to be special speakers. That means that we're gonna be able to get sound from a 3D space. It's not going to be a steady sound. It's going to sound like real life, right? We have sounds that come from all different directions. Also more speakers here in the very top. The connection to the glasses is gonna basically come into this area right here. So this is where you'll connect those. Then we also have some different buttons in here that are going to allow you to change the dimmer features, or better describe as opacity, to block the light from coming into the displays, as well as the volume buttons on the actual AR glasses themselves. There are also two different lenses in here. And if I remember correctly, these were 1920 by 1080 resolution, and they are OLED displays. So they're gonna be angled because the image is projected in a way that you can see it through your eyes. All right guys, so for the next part, we're gonna be connecting the XREAL Beam Pro to the XREAL Air 2 Pro. And in this case, I just have to set up an account, you have to select an avatar, and then once you're ready to go, you basically start the experience. So we're gonna be connecting the display port to the appropriate port. And also if you wanna charge it, as you have it connected, then you should be okay. Notice that I'm using the accelerometer on the actual device as a pointer. In this case, I'm going to Netflix and just showing you the, you know, how I can interact by touching on the Beam Pro screen. We can also select the movie. I didn't want to play it because I don't want to get a copyright notice, but this gives you an idea of how it works. You can also use multitask features, which is really cool. In this case, I have Google Drive on the left side. It's showing as it's on independent application, and also on the right side, I have Chrome, which is currently running Twitter. Also, if the pointer were to get lost or you want to recalibrate it, you just have to press on the home button for a few seconds. And then you can also switch the position of the windows as I'm showing you right now. And then if you wanna look at a video in full screen, you can also do that. In this case, I wanted to show you as well how, in my case, my YouTube channel looks like when looking at it from the glasses. I am scrolling by using touch gestures. You can also look and see how the display looks like. It looks really, really cool. I was really surprised how amazing it looks. You can also change the positioning here, as I'm showing you right now, by holding on the touch area. And then if I want to change applications, I can also do that while I'm playing a video on YouTube. So another cool feature though is the spatial video that they provide. It's really hard to demonstrate how this looks like, but with the glasses, it gives you a better sense of depth. Then another feature that I found really helpful is the ability to toggle between smooth follow and body anchor follow, which is really great if you want to walk around. Basically, this UI is going to follow, it follows your rotation, and then I can also change it to body anchor to basically stay steady as I'm rotating my head. So that's what 3DOF gives you. Here's a better example of how it works. On the left side, we have body anchor, and then on the right side, I have a smooth follow. All right, guys, thank you very much for watching this video today. I hope you enjoy it. If you guys have any questions about any of the devices that I show you today, please let me know in the comments below. And also thank you to all my patrons for supporting my content. I really appreciate it. Thank you very much, everyone.